This video assumes you are using the 4-channel amp to power front and rear speakers already installed on an Ultra Classic. This amp requires no dealer downloads or radio reflashes and includes all required harnesses. Before starting, please remove the seat and undo the two main wires on the battery. Put something over your front fender like a towel just in case something drops during the install. Remove your outer fairing and put aside. Pull up on the Christmas tree fasteners to release each wire harness from the black plate. If your bike has a factory GPS, the small square antenna will need to be relocated just behind the voltmeter as shown. Remove the 4 factory T20 Torque screws that go through the top of the black plate and into the top of the radio. Set these screws aside for now. The amplifier comes pre-mounted to a silver mounting plate. Locate and remove the top 2 screws per side that attach the amp to the silver plate. Put these screws and amplifier aside, noting this is the best time to record the amp serial number in your manual. The amp comes with 4 star washers. Install one on each factory screw and reinstall the screw through the amp plate, through the factory black plate, and into the top of the radio. See the fader, no fader switch on the side of the amp. Since we are installing the amp on an Ultra Classic where we want the radio's fader to control volume between front and rear, the switch on the side of the amp needs to be set to the fader position. As a side note, on non-Ultra models, the switch is put to no fader mode, which activates the 3-position rear channel gain switch, which is then used to adjust the volume of the speakers plugged into the rear channels. Locate the input harness and plug it into the matching connector on the side of the amp. Locate the front output harness and plug it into the front out on the side of the amp. On the long rear harness, you will see 2 white 4-pin connectors on one end. Plug the male one into the rear out on the side of the amp, and the other 4-pin connector onto the matching plug on the input harness. With the harnesses plugged in, sit the amp back into the plate as shown, and once in place, reinstall the 4 screws previously removed so the amp is secured to the plate. The thinner of the 3 wires on the power harness is a remote turn-on lead, and depending when your amp was made, is either yellow or orange. Look for a factory 2-pin plug close to where the GPS antenna was relocated. For reference, the wires on the factory plug are purple with a blue stripe and black. Plug the amp's remote turn-on lead to this factory connector. On the back of the brake side speaker cabinet, you will see wires coming out that go to a connector which needs to be separated. Take the plug from the amp with the blue and black wires and plug it into the speaker side of that factory connector. Take the plug from the amp with the green and black wires and plug it into the radio side of the factory connectors. These connectors will only go on one way and you will hear them click when correctly done. On the clutch side cabinet, undo the same factory speaker wire connector. Take the plug from the amp with the brown and black wires and plug it into the speaker side of the factory connector. Take the plug from the amp with the yellow and black wires and plug it into the radio side of the factory connector. The power and ground harness will pass together under the inner fairing where the main wire harness passes through on the brake side of the bike. The rear harness will pass the same way on the clutch side. Although you can remove the tank to run wires if you choose, we suggest you loosen the tank's chrome console and run wires up and over the gas tank, but under the tank's chrome console. You will see a provision on the front of the tank console for the wires to pass. When correctly installed, the power and ground wires are the right length to connect to the battery. The supplied rear harness is the right length so it can sit on the back fender just behind your seat. You will see a large factory wire plug that needs to be separated. One plug from the Hogtunes rear harness will plug into each side of the factory plug just separated. Attach the amp's red wire to the positive battery terminal and the amp's black wire to the negative battery terminal. The factory battery wires are also reinstalled at this point. When the final of the 2 connectors touches the battery, some sparking is normal. Turn the stereo on and at low volume test to make sure all speakers are working and that the fader on the radio works. This is the best time to clean up and secure the wiring using the supplied zip ties. You will also reattach the factory harnesses to the amp plates as shown. It's very important that you turn your front wheel to each extreme side to make sure the wiring does not impede your steering, noting that failure to do so can cause serious injury. Once you're satisfied your steering is okay, Go ahead and reinstall your seat and your outer fairing, and your new system is ready to enjoy.